Hi YouTube, welcome to my video on how to change a safety valve on a geyser, or popularly known as a TNP valve. It's situated at the back of the geyser, and this is how it looks. What happens is the water pressure in the geyser. Up that spring and causing it to malfunction. So again, convinced that this is the root of this problem and that's causing this valve to malfunction. So looking at some of the specifications on this geyser, it's telling me it's a 100 liter geyser and it's 600 kPa. And then inspection of the valve that I had taken out, it's telling me that it is actually a 400 kPa valve. So there seems to be a mismatch between the valve and the geyser. A qualified plumber had come in and installed the valve the last time, so it looks like they have messed up, and it's one of the reasons that I've now embarked to do these changes myself, hopefully get it right. So I'll take it to the hardware store and have a chat with them more about the mismatch. So this is the new TNP safety valve that I have bought. As you can see, it's a 600 kPa, and you can see the difference in the wear and tear between the two. Just to note, you cannot use a safety valve once you've taken it out and it has gunk and it is dirty. Don't reuse it. Don't even try and clean it, because it will create more problems. Other things I bought, I've just bought a vacuum breaker. I thought I'll change it at the same time. Some hemp and plumbing tape just to help with the installation. Okay, so this is the new safety valve. I've just hand tightened it on a bit. And as you can see there, I've just used some hemp, or you can use plumbing tape just to ensure a better seal. And now I'm just going to tighten it in and use a spanner to secure it. Okay, so YouTube, the new TNP or safety valve has been installed. I've tightened it as best I could and keep it facing down. So now I'm going to turn on the water, fill up the geyser, and we'll test it.